Hello friends, here I have created an app which both starts a service and binds to a service in order to play a media player in this service class. So here is the app. It contains a button 1 at the top, and this can be used to pick an audio file. And here it contains this layout, which contains a linear 1, then it contains this text view 2 and text view 3. Text view 2 is for title, text view 3 is for displaying the duration which is being played and the total duration of the song. Then it contains a seek bar for monitoring the progress of the song, and it contains a play button, which is button 2 in this case. So when I click on this pick file, it opens the downloads folder or the file tree. So here, when I pick this song, it shows the file name here, the total duration here, and this is at 0. So when I click on play, it starts playing, starts updating the progress of seek bar, and starts updating the duration of song which has been played. So initially, when I selected the file, it started the service and also bound to the service. Now when I exit the app, now the service is still started, means it is still created or present, but it is not bound to the service. So now if I again go back to the app, yes, so here is the app. When I again click on this, you can see that it is still bound, means now it binds again. So let's just finish this, and then we will see what the codes are. Yeah, you can see that when song finishes, it becomes initialized. Okay, it becomes unbound. It doesn't become unbound, but it becomes initialized. Actually, when the song finishes, I stop the service. So now the service is not created. So let's have a look at the code. Here in the activity main.xml, I have this button 1, then text view 2, text view 3, seek bar 1, and button 2. Now let's go to main activity.java. First, we'll see this. Player service.java. This is the service class, and here at the top you can see that it extends the service, and it contains this on start command method, which is executed when we start the service, and it has this on bind method, which is executed when we bind to the service for the first time, only for the first time. Then in android manifest.xml, I have declared this service called player service, since this is player service.java and the class name is player service extends this service. At top you can see player service extends service. Now in main activity, initially I have declared all the views, and you can see that some of the views are static because these views I use update in player service. In player service, here you can see I have updated text view to main activity.textview2.setText file name. So in order to use it in player service, I have made them static. So here at top I have declared them, and in onCreate you can see that I have defined all the views, button 1, button 2, text view 2, text view 3, and seek bar 1 using their IDs. Now I also have a shared preferences SP, and this is get shared preferences SP mode private. I have the same shared preferences in player services also. Here in player services, you can see that here at top I have declared a shared preferences SP, and in on start command it is SP equal to get shared preferences SP mode private. So next, the first command which will be executed is button 1 on click. The user will click on button 1 to pick a file. So here I use intent to pick an audio file. And here pick file is the request code. And this pick file is an int variable defined here. Public static final int pick file equal to 99. So in this way I pick the audio file on button one click. So this is done. So it has this start activity for result. And when the file is picked, it will execute on activity result method. This is on activity result method. And here, if the request code is pick file and result code is okay, then if the intent data is not null, then I get the URI of the picked file using this code data.getData. Then I use intent and set it to playerService.class. Then I set the date of this intent to this URI and then I start service. Okay, start service intent. This will start the player service and execute on start command. And after this, I bind to service using a connection and context bind auto create. Okay, so when I call start service, what it will do is it will get the URI from this intent by using intent.getData. Here I had intent.setData URI and now in onStart command I have intent.getData. So here I have declared this URI MURI which I define here. Then for shared preferences, this I showed you. And I have this method createMediaPlayer MURI. So in onStart command, I create the media player using the URI and in the end, I return start sticky. Now I will show you what is this createMediaPlayer block. This I have shown you in one of my previous videos also. So here is this createMediaPlayer URI. So in this, I define the media player. At the top, I have declared this media player and a string variable duration. So and I have declared a string variable file name. Now in create media player, first I define the media player and set audio attributes. Then I set the data source using the URI and then I prepare the media player. After that I have set an on completion listener which tells what happens when the song is completed. So in this I have these two methods, release media player and stop self. Release media player will release the media player and make it null, and it will stop the timer if any is running, and it will initialize the views in main activity. Then stop self will stop the service. Okay, if it will stop the service. So I will just show you release media player also here. In release media player, if timer is not null, then I shut down the timer. Timer is actually a scheduled executor service. And if media player is not null, I release it and make it null. Then for the shared preferences key created, I set the value to false. Means the service is not created now. Earlier, here you can see that when I started the service, I had set it to true. So service created equal to true. And now in shared preferences, it will be created value false. Then for button 2, I disable the button 2. Text view 2, I set this title. And for sigpar 1, I set max to 100 and set progress to 0. So in a way, I initialize the UI. Means make it to the way it was when it started. So this happens when the song is finished. Next, while creating the media player, I get the file name from URI and set it to the string variable file name. And for this also, I have a method called get file name from URI, get name from URI. And this takes the URI, uses cursor, and retrieves the file name as a string variable. Since this is a string variable, it will give us the file name in a string form. So I use this method in create media player to set the string variable file name to the file name. And then I get the duration from media player and set it to int millis. Then I get the total seconds and total minutes. And then the seconds which is left after we subtract the minutes. And then I set it to the string variable duration. That is equal to the minutes plus colon plus seconds. Okay, so in this way I get the duration of the song. So all this happens in create media player. Now what happens after create media player or after the on start command? So after on start command, here you can see that next code is bind service context bind auto create, and it uses connection. For this I have created a service connection, defined a service connection as a new service connection, and it contains these two methods, on service connected and on service disconnected. And I have a boolean variable here called mbound. Here at top you can see that I have a boolean variable mbound and player service called mService. So on service connected I set mbound to true, on service disconnected I set mbound to false. Now this on service connected method contains an ibinder called service, and that ibinder is what it gets from on bind method. So here when I bind service it will execute on bind, but this will be executed only the first time I bind to the service. If the service is already running, then it will not execute on bind again. When I bind service again, it will only execute on service connected. So here it will execute on bind and this returns binder, and whatever this ibinder binder is, that we can get in on service connected. Here you can see this ibinder service. Okay, this we will get from on bind method. So if we have to execute these methods, which is like update media data or get name from URI or release media player, okay, or play or pause or update playing time or seek media player, if we have to use this in main activity, then we have to get the service in on bind. So for that I have defined a new class called local binder. Okay, this local binder is binder, it extends binder, and it contains a method called get service which gives me this player service, which is this service. So what is local binder? It is a binder, and why I have created it? To get the player service. So here I define an ibinder binder is equal to new local binder, and in onBind method, here in onBind method I return this binder. Now in main activity I define this player service dot local binder. This is player service and this is local binder. So player service dot local binder binder is equal to this service, and I convert it to player service dot local binder by writing this in bracket. Next I define this player service equal to binder dot get service. Here I showed you that it contains get service method which will give me player service. So in main activity at the top I have declared player service as m service, and in on service connected I define this m service as binder dot get service. So now I got the player service and I can use it. So here if m service is not null, then I update media data. So next step will be update media data. When it is bound and connected, it will update the media data. Update media data means for TextView2 it will display the file name it will enable button 2 and it will get the duration from media player, and display, it will display the duration in main activity, and it will set the max of sigpar 1 to this duration of song in milliseconds and set the progress of sigpar 1 to 0. So this is update media data. Next step will be, so once it is bound and connected, the user will now click on the play button, which is button 2. Since we activated button 2, now here you can see button 2 set enabled true. Now user can click on button 2. So when button 2 is clicked, if service is bound, if I am bound, then I execute mService.play or pause. I have already defined mService in on service connected. So now I can use mService. So here I will use mService.play and pause, play or pause. And I have this play or pause method in this player service. In this method, if the media player is not null, and if media player is playing, then I pause the media player, and for button 2 I set text to play and shut down the timer. This timer is actually scheduled executor service. I will just show you. Here at top I have declared scheduled executor service timer. Now we go back. So if media player is not playing, then when button is clicked, I start the media player and set text of button 2 to pause. Then I define the schedule executor service as new schedule thread pool with size 1. And then I schedule it at fixed rate. Schedule the timer to run at fixed rate of 10. Means schedule fixed rate of every 10 milliseconds. So it will repeat or run every 10 milliseconds. And what it will repeat? If media player is not null and if sigpar 1 in main activity is not pressed, then for sigpar 1 it will set the progress to get current position, the current position of the song. So every 10 milliseconds it will set the progress of sigpar 1 to current position of song. This is the play or pause button. So once it changes the position, then the next event which will be automatically executed will be sigpar 1 on progress changed. In this event, if it is bound to service, then I update the playing time. I use mService once again, mService.updatePlayingTime, and in player service I have this method update playing time. Here if media player is not null, then I get the current position of media player, the current position at which the song is playing, and I get that position or time in milliseconds. Then I convert it to seconds and minutes, and then I get the seconds left by subtracting the minutes from total seconds, and then I display the minutes and seconds of the time which shows the current position of song divided by the duration of the song. So this is update playing time. That will be updated in text view 3 of main activity. So this is done in on progress changed. So next, suppose the user moves the sigpar to a certain position and releases it there. So in that case, I have this on stop tracking touch method, where if it is bound, then I execute mService.seekMediaPlayer. And in this seekMediaPlayer, here you can see this method seekMediaPlayer. So here if media player is not null, then I seek to sigpar1.getProgress. So whatever is the progress of sigpar, the media player will move to that position and start playing the song from that position. So this is done. And initially the button 1 is set enabled false. So it is enabled only on only when the service is connected. Okay, so suppose the user exits the app while the song is playing. In that case, the service will be created, but it will be unbound. It will automatically unbind the service. So for when the user comes back, for that I have this on start method. But when the user exits the app, I have on stop method. And here, if service is not null and if it is bound, then it unbinds the service. Okay, it will unbind the service, but it will not stop the service. So service will keep running and song will keep playing, but it will unbind the service. So when the app starts again, I have to bind the service. So here, if it is not bound and if the shared preferences key created value is true, then I again use intent and bind service method to bind to the service. So that's all in this video. In Android manifest, we have to declare this service. I have shown you the app. This is the app where we can pick file and play the song. We can seek to any position. It will start playing from that position. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.